Today, I'll be doing a video on Grave Intentions. I didn't know what to expect from this movie. It looked mildly interesting from the previews. It's an anthology with 5 different untraditional horror stories. Just to start off, I surprisingly enjoyed this and have some respect for it because it doesn't go the usual creep show, crypt keeper route where the villains magically face karma. Quite frankly, I'm sick of those types of plots. It's a been there, done that formula. That's not to say this is a perfect movie. I did have some problems with it. We're introduced to a voodoo woman. At first, I didn't mind her, but as the movie goes on, her monologues became winded. On repeat viewing, I would fast forward her parts just to get to the stories. The first story is about a woman who longs to fit in with others and to be seen. She joins a bridge club and is later threatened by a woman who was seemingly nice to her at first, who looks like an older version of Kaylee Cuoco, by the way, and now she fears for her life. This had a nice beginning and middle, and then falls flat by the ending. It ends right when you think something else is gonna happen. And I'm not even sure what I'm watching. Upon second viewing, I think I have a better idea of what's going to happen next. The second story is about a murderer who faces a different form of the death penalty. Instead of death, the family of the victim gets to decide which limb he loses. The convict is also made to visit schools to warn kids not to commit crimes. I thought this was unbelievably cruel, although if my loved one was brutally murdered, I don't know how I'd feel, so it's hard to judge. Not only does the family get to witness this convict getting his limbs cut off, they get to decide how far they can go with it. So that's where the story really gets messed up. Like, it's a very interesting story, and the acting is pretty good, even though the narration is the most dialogue that you get from this. But the facial acting, you can really feel the tension. You can see how the characters feel just by their face. But yeah, I didn't like the narration, and I had to turn on the subtitles, but I did like the story overall way more the second time I watched it. The third story is about a strange, maybe socially awkward woman who saves a stray cat from being abused by a group of losers. Then things take a violent turn. I really did not like this one because I am a huge cat lover, and I don't like seeing cats being harmed in any way, even when it's obvious they're using a stuffed animal at times. Still, it was realistic looking enough to where I was still deeply upset. However, some people may even find the humor in this. It was a more serious version of Scary Movie 2 with Sydney and the cat duking it out because she used the cat's litter box. The fourth story was my favorite out of all of them. It basically involves a mom who is cruel to her son while giving him life lessons about what to do in an emergency. I definitely don't want to give away what is going on. You should see it for yourself. Towards the middle, I was able to guess everything that was going to happen 10 seconds before it did, but it was still enjoyable. The ending, however, was unpredictable, and my jaw dropped. And that is all I will say about that. Go watch it. Fifth and last story is about a girl who is being abused and uses her imagination to get her through it. This was decent, but didn't leave a lasting impression like the others did. I give this a 6 out of 10. It was entertaining. It definitely got better as it went along. So 6 out of 10, and I do recommend.